It's my feel good breakfast show.
Welcome to your feel good breakfast show. This individual over here, I've missed him. He is the person that'll give you exactly what you need to know about the movies releasing today. He is basically a walking trailer. He doesn't live in one, but he will tell you a bit more about the movie. Jeremy Sebastian, what an honor and a pleasure to have you here because you got three movies.
You just want to write my memoir.
I do want to.
How about I join the WWE and you announce me?
I would love to be that guy.
I'll be your Undertaker and you can be my...
Yes. Oh, I could do that. But okay, let's go to the movies.
The director said talk about the movies.
Yes, I know.
But just pro wrestling
no fun career, today, clearly. Anyway, let's get to the business of the movies. Right. Let's start off. Ticket to Paradise.
First time that we saw these two together. It surprises people. Like, you feel like
Ocean's 11.
Yeah.
That's it.
Oh, that's correct.
She was Tess Ocean. And he is Danny Ocean.
Oh, no. It's so dumb that the name is Ocean. Even though I love that movie. No, Steven Soderbergh is amazing. Loved it. And obviously, the chemistry there was amazing, too. But it feels like they have been together for much prior to that. But still, that's like 20... No, no, that's not 20 years. It's 20 years since Julia Roberts has done a rom-com. So this is a big return, I suppose.
What is the last one?
Good question.
My Best Friend's Wedding or Notting Hill?
I don't know. This goes back to obviously Pretty Woman. It makes you wonder, where's Richard Gere? Like, is he even on that plane? Like, is he involved in this? Did he get a ticket to Paradise? Where is Richard Gere? It's another question for another day. George Clooney, Julia Roberts, the story being is that instead of being two lovebirds and sparks flying and romance or whatever, it seems like it's obviously a clever bent here that they're a divorced couple. They hate each other, they're at each other's throats. I think that this is a dynamic that we've seen a couple of times before. Even here in South Africa, we had Keeping Up with the Kandasamis, where they were trying to break up the children's marriage type situation. And yeah, they feel like they don't want their daughter to make the same mistake. She's falling into a whirlwind romance with the dude, and he seems like a nice enough guy who they're seeing there, but throughout, George Clooney and Julia Roberts seem to be trying to sabotage. But obviously the game of sabotaging the relationship draws them closer together, and sparks refly between the fly bunch and your faves, George Clooney and Julia Roberts. Shame, she's... Oh, why do I say shame? She's like plenty richer than me. She doesn't live in like a trailer like I do. such a naturalistic kind of like character. And George Clooney, he's got this instinct, people forget, for comedy himself. Whether it was Burn After Reading, whether it was Hail Caesar, et cetera, et cetera. So yeah, he brings apparently a super amount of goofiness. So he's not like super slick and suave and whatever. But whatever, find out for yourself coming out today in South Africa.
I think it's going to be phenomenal. Honestly, I love those two in a movie together as well. There's good energy, good chemistry, and it looks like a big trip of fun. In fact, talking about big trip of fun, let's go to another movie, an animated movie. Yes. I love these. I'm a passionate animated supporter.
Let's see.
And I look at this one. You know what I love? I love the panda. Panda. I've seen the panda.
The panda looks nonplussed. Like he wants the bunny to die.
That's the thing. And the thing about the panda in this movie, I feel like people for Halloween have been dressing up as this panda for years.
You mean muggers. It looks like a balaclava, doesn't it? It's a problem with the animation in this, as far as I'm concerned. That bunny's lats, by the way. Like, he's holding... Okay, let's talk about the movie. Sorry,
yes,
sorry.
Yes, please, focus on the movie.
The big trip. Clearly about drugs. No, sorry.
No.
Not about tripping. I'm being silly. It's a kid's animation. It's one, I think, primarily maybe for your littlest toddlers.
Okay.
Not necessarily for, like, over, let's say, 8 or whatever. I just mean humor-wise. Maybe it won't be for them. Maybe it will be for them. You decide for yourselves as a parent. Maybe I can help you out. But the story being is that this follows up from a previous movie where a similar thing happened. So now a bunny, a bear, and this panda have to team up. Panda previously in the movie was the baby in the situation. This time there's a new baby on board. And this odd couple, this odd group, this strange ad hoc family have to try and get this baby that is lost by the storks to the family it belongs to.
Yes.
So it's very similar to Ice Age. You know, the mammoth, you've got Sid the Sloth, who's the bunny in this situation. You've got a literal tiger in this movie too. But guys, like, there've got to be other, like, it doesn't look bad, right? But like, George,
Stanky
guys. Like, Toy Story's from 1995, that's all I have to say. Like, Toy Story 1, and it looks remarkable. Shame, and in these kinds of animations, because look, it's not like a major studio or anything like that, but you can see someone broke their butt making that blimp look good. And then the bunny person was just like, I don't care, it doesn't have to obey physics. I mean, like, it could look edible, it could not, who knows? It's been like dead droids for all I care. The panda looks like it's a robber in a balaclava because it doesn't have a skeleton underneath it.
That's what I was gonna say. It looks like they animated this thing like a guy in a suit, but it's fine. It looks like fun.
We're being very polite. Look, bright colors, propulsive, like roller coasters, all that kind of stuff. Kids appreciate it. Look,
nice.
If it's moving fast enough, maybe it will capture their imagination enough. Big trip 2 out today too. Special delivery.
All right, so Ticket to Paradise, Big Trip 2, and now we've got a movie that's re-releasing in the eve of the Way of Water.
It's the call show.
December, Avatar. Dude. Is out in IMAX 3D, and I am freaking out because this is one of the triumphs, the only movie to beat Avengers Endgame. It was actually a bit of a
go for it. Set yourself free. I'm just gonna sit back.
It's wonderful, and I think it's a movie that will capture your mind, and I think it's a movie that also plays on a lot of history, a lot of history all over. When any sort of colonialist entered a country and took the resources, there was a natural, harmonious tribe that was there. And I think watching them play out in this particular movie was an absolute triumph. And I watch it again and again.
For younger audiences, to try and bring in that historical account,
yes.
It's not a bad entry point. But look, you've got major names. You've got Sam Worthington, Zoe Saldana. You've got,
James Cameron.
James Cameron returning, the guy who did Titanic, the guy who did Terminator, the guy who did Aliens. You've only got 2 weeks, South Africa, on IMAX. One of the biggest screens possible, and probably the way it should have been enjoyed in the first place. Get lucky this weekend, maybe go and see Avatar. It's total escapist fun, but at the same time, like you said, with this interesting historical account and bend to it, bright, lush colors, beautiful walls. James Cameron is one of the most audacious human beings. He was like, I will build a boat for Titanic. And then this just like imagines a world that doesn't exist there, but pretty similar to stuff like Pocahontas, et cetera, et cetera. And like you say, colonial history, et cetera, et cetera. Out today in South Africa. Who cares about all that? Go see it on the biggest screen you can.
Three movies. Enjoy your weekend. Thanks to JP Sebastian. And go to the movies and go support Avatar this weekend.